ear.
We receive the prayer today. We receive the blessing today.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are not a crowd. It's possible for me to pray.
Amen.
For each one of you.
Thank you,
Jesus. You need the blessing.
Amen.
Only the blessing can remove the curse.
Amen.
Only the blessing can bring change.
Amen.
When the blessing is upon someone, you cannot stop that person. You cannot bring that person down. Because the blessing is on him. Hallelujah. The blessing makes the difference. And today the difference will come upon your life. Put your hands together for Jesus. God bless you. Check your seat. Greet the person sitting next to you. Say, this day is your day. Hallelujah. My trust is in you, Lion of Judah. My trust is in you. I put a money you.
I put a money you.
Yeah.
My trust is in you.
I put a money you.
I put a money
you. Yeah.
My trust is in you.
Lion of Judah. My trust is in you. That I am, that I am. My trust is in you. Yahweh, I put him on you.
I put him on you.
Yeah, yeah. My trust is in you. But I put him on you.
I put him on you.
Yeah, yeah.
My trust is in you.
All I own of Judah. My trust is in you. That I am, that I am God. My trust is in you. Shiloh, I put him on you.
I put him on you.
Yeah, yeah.
My trust is in you.
Father, I put him on you.
I put him on you.
Yeah, yeah. My trust is in you. Together for Jesus. My trust is in Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love this song, and it sings in my heart every time. My trust. The Bible says that blessed be the man who put his trust in the Lord. He will be like a tree planted close to the water. He will always produce fruit because of his connection with the Lord. But cursed is the man who put his trust in another man. Hallelujah. You see, it is dangerous to activate the curse yourself. It's better for people to curse you. God will defend you. Amen. When witches are cursing you, God will fight for you. But if yourself, not witches, but you activate the curse. How do you activate the curse? When you transfer your trust on a man. He said, my auntie promised me. My uncle promised me. My friend promised me. I trust what the man taught me. You focus there. You say, I know He will not deceive me. I put my trust. And when God realized that your trust is no longer on him, but is on a man, you are cursed. Your plan will be cursed. Your project will be cursed. Your business will be cursed. Your academies will be cursed. If you want the blessing, trust God. God will use men. But you let God use men. You keep trusting God. Hallelujah. The Bible says that men can receive only what comes from heaven. If I give you money today, it's not me. It is God using me to give you. If I give you a car today, it's not me. It is God giving you the car through me. If I give you clothes today, it is not me. It is God using me. Because you cannot see God physically, God will use men. Trust the Lord who uses men. Don't trust the men who are used by God. Hallelujah. Men can promise me. I say, okay, thank you, but I trust the God to use him to fulfill his promise. If God does not give him the power, he may have the willingness, but he will not do it. Hallelujah. Because men are limited. If men don't fulfill the promise, it does not mean that he does not love you or he does not like you. No, the problem is man is limited. Man is limited in time. It means that man cannot live forever. He will die one day. Hallelujah. Man is limited in power. Hallelujah. Man is limited in resources. Only God is unlimited. Hallelujah. Only God is unlimited. So this morning I'm telling someone here, direct your trust on God. He will never deceive you. He will never die. He will never forsake you. God can make a way where there is no way. Men can tell you, if I could do it, but I don't have all the means. God always have resources. There cannot be lack in heaven. God will never lack people. God will never lack money. God will never lack connection. God has it all. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said, if you stop these people from pressing me, those stones will begin to press me. God can use even stones. God can use even animals. God can use even people that you don't know. And they call you, they say, God is putting in my heart to bless you. God can use what you don't know. Hallelujah. Because he's God. Put your trust in the Lord. I'm speaking to someone here. Put your trust. It is a prophecy. I'm starting my preaching with a prophecy. Put your trust in the Lord. Keep praising him. Trust in the God. Lion of Judah, my trust is on you, not on a man. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I gave you my testimony when we were in lockdown. I was surprised people calling me from Canada, from Europe, sending me money in Western Union. They are not part of my church. I'm not their pastor, but they just say, look at me. How many pastors were going on Facebook? Many pastors. How can someone just pick you? He said, God told me to send you this man. Do I know you? No. Pastor, they write you in messenger. Send me your name, your details. I want to bless you. Amen. And I receive money like that. A lot of money. People that I never see, I don't know them, I don't pray with them. This is what God can do. When you have a need, sitting there, say, how am I going to pay the rent? Now we are in lockdown. I don't know what will happen. Someone just called you. Pastor, can I know how much you pay your rent in South Africa? I'm in Canada. God told me to pay the rent for you this month. Oh, bless God. Bless God. Bless God. This can happen to you as you're sitting there. Amen. This can happen to someone. Can ask you, I see that you have a project. How much do you need for the project to be fulfilled? Amen. All that you must have a vision. Right vision. Clear vision. Be a man with a vision. If you don't have a vision, the provision will not come. Sometimes people don't know what they need. Yourself, you don't know what you need right now. That's why you don't see the miracle. If someone comes to you now, you say, no, stand up. How much money do you need? Then say, give me a day, I will come back to you tomorrow. Be ready every time. You know, okay, what I'm looking for now. Not be confused. What is your vision? I need a business. That business requires 30,000 rand. So I trust God for that. I want to travel, it requires this. I want to pay to buy a new house. Amen. Even though you have no rent, but you know that what kind of house do you want? If you ask me now, I'll tell you. Try. Tell you, no, this is the house that I want. This kind of bedroom, this amount. Which area? I'll tell you quick. If you have your money, give me. But if they ask you, what do you want? You are still far from the miracle. Do you know your budget? How much do you lack? It must be in your mind. And trusting God, you are able to make a way where there is no way. Hallelujah. And what I like, God, the Bible said that God can do above everything you ask and you imagine. What I like with God, if in your mind you have 30,000, God will always give you 35 or 40 to prove you that I am God. I always go a little bit above your vision. Amen. So as you are sitting there, that situation is over. You are blessed today. It is a prophecy for you. God is going to use someone that you don't know. Forget the one who said that I can't do it. Forget. Hallelujah. Say, you are a man, I understand. You can be limited, I understand. I still love you. Don't hate people. Oh. Amen. So if I promise you to give you 200, I don't give now, you see me, you are passing. Don't pass me. Just say, greet me, love me. Just say, pray for me. Because if you keep love in your heart, God will bring new people. But if you keep hatred, God will never bring new people. Your heart must be pure in order for you to see the hand of God. Hallelujah. Don't make a mistake. No, they promise me, they don't give me, I hate them. No, love them because they are people. But God will bring new people in your life. God will make a way where there is no way. God will surprise someone here. Hallelujah. I prophesy upon your month. This month of May is the month of surprise. I declare and I decree surprises in your life. I prophesy for you, you will be surprised. God is going to come in a way you don't know. God is going to confuse your mind. God is going to shut the mouth of your enemy. I declare your plan will come to pass. I declare your dream will come to pass. Receive the grace in May. Receive the favor in May. Shout, I am blessed. Shout again, I am blessed. Shout loudly, I am blessed. Put your hand together for Jesus. Hallelujah. God bless you. God bless you. Growing in intimacy with God. I gave you 2 points. Let's go straight to the third point today. Growing in intimacy. Put me those points on the screen that I gave already. Then we go point number three. You don't want to repeat again to waste our time. Hallelujah. You grow in intimacy with God by developing the spirit of gratitude. Being grateful to the Lord will cause you every time to pray. Number two, developing the passion for His presence and His power. Hallelujah. It helps you. Now let's take number three. The spirit of total. Say after me, total. Dependence on God. This will cause you to pray. Someone with the mentality of depending totally on God will never miss to pray. Hallelujah. Because you will ask me, why other people don't pray? Why other people are so weak in prayer? The reason is because they have other alternative. They are using their brain. They are using the strategy. They have plan B's. If this don't work, I know myself. There are people who always know. Me, I know. When they sit there, they are thinking. They go deeper in thinking. They are traveling. Even in the church, they are still thinking. Amen. Someone sitting in the church, but his mind is not in the church because he's busy thinking. Be careful with those who are great thinkers. You'll become crazy one day. Hallelujah. Fix your mind on God. Hallelujah. Total dependence on God. Let's read John chapter 15, verse 5. John 15, verse 5. The Bible says, okay, let's read it together, all of us. Let's preach together. 1, 2, 3, read. Yes.
Mm-hmm. He who abides in me,
yes,
and I in him,
yes,
bears much fruit.
Mm-hmm.
For without me, you can do nothing.
Hallelujah. So I want you to read the last phrase again loudly. Four, one, two, three.
For without me, you can do nothing.
Say it again.
For without me, you can do nothing.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Did you get that? The Bible says, this is Jesus speaking. He said, I am the vine. You are the branches. So I'm the trunk of the tree. You are the branches connected to the tree. Amen. Hallelujah. He's telling you who you are. In his eyes, who are you? A branch. And he said, he who abides in me, it means he who is connected. Say connection. Anyone who is connected to me is what they say. He will bear much fruit. Amen. He will have results. He will have testimony every week and every month. The reason there is no testimony, check the connection. Check what? Check what? Hallelujah. Are you really connected to Jesus? If you are connected to him, you receive life from him. Jesus is the life, is the source of life. He is the way, he is the truth, he is life himself. He's the bread of life. Jesus is the morning star. Jesus is Alpha and Omega. Jesus is the beginning of everything. Jesus is the healer. Jesus is the protector. Jesus is the deliverer. When you are connected to him, you receive deliverance. You are connected to him, you receive healing. You are connected to him, you receive miracle. Your connection with Jesus will determine the number of the fruit in your life. Hallelujah. If you want more fruit, check what? The connection. He said clearly, without me, without me, you can do nothing. Many times we are trying our best. Your problem is you have been trying for long. You understand? Every time myself, I know myself, I study, I've got my papers, I've got my document, I know myself, I know myself, myself I can do. He said, no. Before anything, seek me first. Don't trust even your papers that you have. Don't trust your knowledge. Don't trust your diploma. Don't trust your network. Don't trust. Say that everything, first of all, it is God. Without me, you cannot make it. It is the key for life. Amen. Sometimes you are pushing much, you are pushing much, you are pushing much, you are having a little result. You think that you are living. You are not living, you are still surviving. That is not life. Jesus came to give you life in abundance. For you to have life in abundance, you need to put him first. To connect first with him before you connect with people. Connect with God. And if you understand this, you will never neglect God. You will never go into the church. You will never neglect praying. You will never neglect reading the Bible. You will put God first and all the rest will come. Our problem today, God is not first. God is not first. When you wake up in the morning, God is not first. Amen. Learn to depend totally on God. It is a great secret for success in life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is what my biggest secret in life. I always tell people, my wife can testify, my children can testify. I pray for anything. Everything in my life, I pray for them. I don't do anything myself thinking, then I do it. No, no. I always tell God. Amen. If even I tell you, Loic, we're going to meet on Tuesday, 3 at my place. If I tell you that, I will pray for that. Say, God, as Loic is coming at my place Tuesday, 3 p.m., I pray that you bless our conversation. I pray that you speak. I will never say, no, it's normal. Loic will come 3 p.m., it's normal. I never see anything normal. I pray for everything. If I wake up in the morning, I know already that today my plan was to go in Parkland or I will go in the mall. I know that. I will mention that in my prayer in the morning. Father, as I will leave today, as I will go to the mall, Even the place that I don't know will go today, I pray for your direction. If there is something bad, take me away from that. Every visit, everything that is not of you, I pray, rescue me from that. Give me wisdom to make right choices today. Father, before I will lift my phone in the morning, I say, God, before I begin to use this phone today, receiving calls, then I pray for wisdom. Any call that will deviate me from you, I pray it will not enter my phone today. Anyone who will call me, give me wisdom to answer. I depend totally on God. I don't say, no, I'm a pastor, I read the Bible. I don't know. I cannot think like that. I depend totally. Even the little details, I depend. God, when you depend, he will give you wisdom. When you depend, he will direct you. Even a little mistake, he will tell you, careful, don't do this. Even when someone is lying to you, you stand, you are about to say, to accept, you feel that soft voice, liar. And then you feel good, and God is telling me the guy is lying. You feel good when you feel that presence around you. You will finish the year without a bad report, without mistake. Not because you are smart, but because you depend on God. Every choice, every decision were led by His Spirit. You kneel down to ask Him, I am connected. Without you, there's nothing I can do. Hallelujah. I prefer to finish the year. I don't have much money. But if you ask me the mistake that I committed in the year, I prefer to say, no. I don't see any mistake. Everything God helped me on my decision. If there's something, maybe little thing, but not you're sitting there. If I remember, yeah, my heart, when I remember this thing, my heart. No! It happened to us when we neglect God, when we don't put Him in our deals, when we don't put Him in our decision, when we don't put Him in our choices, we will end up crying. Total dependence on God. And Father, I depend on you. There are even food on the street, food in the shop that are poisoned by evil powers. When you depend on God, He can tell you, don't move in this room. Don't touch this thing. God can speak to you like that. Clearly. Amen. Because you never believe your own intelligence. You never believe your own. No, I don't trust myself. Me, I don't trust. I only trust God. If He tells me to move, I will move. People are dead today because of stupidity. Going where you are not supposed to go. Associating with people that you don't supposed to associate. At the end, your life is destroyed. Why? Because you don't depend on God. You believe you are intelligent. I pray for you today. Stop thinking you are smart. Hallelujah. Stop thinking you are intelligent. Begin to depend on God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There is a party somewhere. They invite you. Begin to pray for the party. Father, I pray for that party. You know what will happen there. If it is your will for me to go there, open the way for me to go. If it is not your will, block me to not go. God will make a way. If it's not His will, He knows how to block you. He can even give you sickness that day. You sleep on the bed. That's for the day. Tomorrow you are fine. He stopped you from not going there. God can even break your car by force. The car was fine. You start. The car is refusing to. Why? Leave it. He knows that the accident is on the road. It's broken. You stay there. Because you are senseless. You don't understand. Nothing happened by mistake here. God is ruling my life. This is a sign. Something is happening. And you sit quiet. Don't see anything negative. You see this bed. Certain negative stuff are the sign from God. He's protecting you. Hallelujah. He's preventing you from something that you don't know. But it will happen to you only if you depend on God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So someone who depends on God will not forget to pray. How can you forget? Because before I go out here, I need to say something. How will you forget? It's impossible to forget. Because in your heart already know, I depend on God. Amen. I depend on God. No one can come just lie to you so easily and take your money so easily. No. You depend on God. When it is a scam, you realize this is a scam. It's a lie. you can sense. Amen. So this is something that you must develop. Amen. And you have to understand that prayer is the sign of humility. Pray. When you see someone praying, it shows that he's a humble person. Because when you are humble, you say, "No, I cannot make it alone. I depend on God." You will always kneel. Father, thank you for the day. Father, thank you for your grace. Father, pray for my life. I put my life in your hand. I put my destiny in your hand. You are so humble. That's why you pray. A proud person will never ask, will never pray. Can't you see that? Arrogant people. He does not have things. You want even to give him, he say, "No, it's okay, it's okay." Arrogant. Some people, they are suffering. They are hungry, but because of pride, they don't want. Amen. In South Africa, we have those people that we do their job houseless, seeing on the street. Those people that without houses, we call them the Maibru. There's nothing that the government is doing for them. You go in America, they are building shelters for them. Beautiful. All the shelters are empty. The shelters are empty. Beautiful shelters. Then you ask them, why the shelters are empty? They tell you, Americans are too proud. People who are jobless, they still want to look like they are people. They have something. They feel so much that they cannot go to the shelter. And it is difficult for you to know. In South Africa, you know the Maipu. You see the way. In America, only an American guy will tell you, this guy is a homeless. He has to tell you. They know. The homeless are walking nice with the tackies, with the nice jean jacket. But you see, they have the bags on the back. And they go to the gym in the morning. They take shower for free. You take shower. Then they sit, and then the way they walk, they are placed that they are sitting. They sit, you sometimes sit in the park reading a book. They will tell you, see that guy reading that magazine? Homeless. You see that one? But when they walk, they don't want, they come at the church want to offer them shit. They refuse. It is in the blood. Too proud. Too arrogant. In South Africa, if you build a beautiful shelter like this for free and food, it will be packed in 30 minutes. Packed. Amen. And you will see other people, they are struggling. You are struggling with something. You sit on your laptop, you don't know what to do. Someone asks you, "Can I help you?" "Oh no, I got it, don't worry. I got it, don't worry, got it." Your husband is asking you, can I do? "Oh, I know what I do." You always know. Do it. You are turning around left, right. Arrogant people don't want help. They don't want to ask. He's lost. I'm looking for Wetten Road number 3. He's already in Spinner Road. You see people coming. Say, ask them. I'll see funding. He's still walking, wasting his time. Ask. I don't want to ask. If I ask, they will see like I'm stupid. Arrogant people don't ask. You are lost. You don't ask. You are broke. They are asking you, "Can we bring you food at home?" "Oh no, it's fine. It's fine. We already ate. It's fine. God is in control. It's fine." Hallelujah. Prayer is the sign of humility. That Father, I'm so lost here, God. Father, I'm so broke. My God, without you, people will mock on me. I trust you to open a door. I trust you to make a way. I trust you to heal my family. I trust you. When you are humble, you will pray. You will wake up in the night. They see you kneeling down crying because you are humble. Hallelujah. Arrogant people will not cry. Even in front of God, they are boasting. Front of God. They are still showing God that, "Oh, no, God. Me, I can't show you that. Me. is praying with arrogance. Father God, I thank you. In the name of Jesus, you are God. If you want to do it, you do it. If you don't want, you don't want. And I can't cry, I can't fall. Ah! What kind of arrogance? Be humble. Hallelujah. Without me, you cannot make it. You will not do it. You will not succeed. Amen. Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. Let's read that one. And then we are going to pray. Today is the day of blessing for each one of us here. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't worry. Let's read it, all of us. 1, 2, 3. Shout. Stop there. Say it again.
Don't worry about anything.
Say it again.
Don't worry about anything.
So now look at your neighbor. Say it to your neighbor, that face. Say it. Anything means anything. Don't worry about anything. Don't worry about money. Don't worry about marriage. Don't worry about children. Don't worry about the house. Don't worry about the car. Don't worry about the position. Don't worry about anything. But in all your prayers, ask God for what you need. You understand? Be humble. In all your prayer, ask God for what you need. Don't say, no, God himself, he knows everything. He's omniscient. I don't want to tell him. If he want to bless me, he'll bless me. If he don't want, his God. No, he knows everything, but he wants you to say it. You get to say, God, I am in trouble here. You are my father. You are my provider. I know you can make a way. I know you can give me the solution. I know you can wipe away my tears. I know, God, you are able. You get to tell him your need in where? Prayer. You don't tell him your need in your heart. Oh, as I'm sitting there, I'm speaking in my heart. Pray. Organize a time. Amen. All he said, always asking him with a thankful heart. It is the key. Amen. When you pray with thanksgiving, it means that because I believe, because I trust God, because I know he's able, I thank him already. Hallelujah. I pray with a thankful heart. You need a car. You begin to say, Father, I stand in front of your throne. And I pray, I trust that you are God who is able to give me anything that I want. Look, my need, Father, right now I need a car for my transportation. And I pray that you open the way for me to have a car. I thank you, God, that you always answer our prayer. I thank you, God, that you are able to do that. I thank you, God, that you have blessed me already. You must always be thankful. Hallelujah. You are thankful. You remember the past. If God helps you. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes, because when you come in front of God, for example, Ruth did not have money for the transport last week. But God blessed her with the money. And today, she does not have the money for the transport. And she wants to pray God to give her money. Right now, because she does not have money, it is an issue. Every issue will touch your heart, will touch your emotion. You understand? We are human beings. We are not spiritual. We are not angels. When there is no food, there is no food. You will not cooperate with your tummy. It will fight you. You feel like, no, there is a need here. Because there is a need. Sometimes as a human being, you have a little sorrow. See, in your heart, you're a bit concerned. This is a need. Amen. But God is telling you, the secret for me to give you again this money today is when you come in front of me, don't forget in your mind that I gave you the same miracle yesterday. So now be thankful in your heart. You understand? Believing that he can still do it again today. So when I pray with the attitude of thanksgiving, not with sorrow, not with complaint. I say, Father, I come to you. I trust that you are God who can make a way. I need money for transport again today. And I thank you, God, that you are making a way. I thank you, God, that you are providing. Before you see it, thank God. Hallelujah. Before you touch your miracle, thank God. The miracle that you thank God for will come quick. Can I repeat that? The miracle that you thank God for will come quick. I say it again. The miracle that you thank God for will come quick. Can I tell you again? The miracle that you thank God for will come quick. This is the miracle that always comes. Because before you see it, you are thanking God. God has created you and me like Him. We have the soul, we have the spirit in us. Amen. Hallelujah. When some people are asking you things, they look at you. They say, I like that jacket that Rumbi is wearing. And then Rumbi send a picture in Zimbabwe. And his sister, look at the jacket. I like that jacket. And then, the quick way to get the jacket. ISIS, nice jacket, yeah? Please. Someone is coming Zim next month. Please send me that jacket. Thank you in advance. That word thank you in advance is a trap. People, when they ask you money from Congo, for them to push you to give it, merci en avance. You feel like, hey, thank you in advance. I already thank you. You see, if I don't give, he already said thank you. I like those shoes. If you send me, thank you in advance. I thank you all in advance for your gift. No gift is there. We are telling people, hi guys, I know that you're going to come in my party. I thank you in advance for your gift. And then they feel like, he's already thanking us for the gift. We need to buy the gift. But if we go without the gift, maybe you'll support me so much. We need just to bring the gift. Amen. We need to bring the gift because he already thanked us. Amen. The same thing with God. The miracle, Jesus was praying like that. He saw the tomb of Lazarus and said, Father, I thank you that you have already answered me. Lazarus is still in the tomb. He said, I thank you, Father, that you have already answered me. But I'm just praying for these people to see that I depend on you. And then he said, Lazarus, come out. He came out. But he thanked God before Lazarus coming out. But to you, you say, Father, until my Lazarus comes out, no thank you. I'm waiting. I'm waiting. If I don't touch the miracle, no thank you. Change the formula. With a thankful heart. Your heart is thankful. You believe my prayer is answered. Can someone believe that this May is already blessed for him? That God has already answered you? That the deed is already done? That nothing is impossible this month? The grace is already released upon your life? Can someone believe that? Say, oh Lord, I thank you in advance.
Thank you in advance.
That this month of May,
I
shall have a testimony. In the name of Jesus. All my ways are good.
All my doors are open.
Favor is upon my life. In the name of Jesus. Put your hands together for Jesus celebrating. Hallelujah. Let's finish with this scripture and then we pray. Psalm. No, let me read again the same scripture in the Message version. As you put Message version. Message version. All of us, can we see that? 1, 2, 3.
Don't worry.
Yes.
Instead of worrying, pray.
Yes.
Let petitions and praises shape your worries,
yes,
into prayers.
Yes.
Letting God know your concerns.
Hallelujah. Don't fret, don't worry. Instead of worrying. Instead of worrying. The Bible said that. Let your petition and praises shape your worries. Amen. Hallelujah. Let your praise shape. Let your praise give a form to your worries. Something was worrying me, but I put music in my house. Hallelujah. You raise the volume in your bedroom. You begin to jump. Tambira Jehovah. But there is an issue there waiting for you. But you know, let me praise. Let praise give another form to your worries. Hallelujah. Let praise give another form to your worries. That's why you see the people of this world, when they are in trouble, they decide, let me go to the bar. When it comes, they say, give me 2 strong ones. They give you 1. The second one, oh God, Now, that wine is creating another atmosphere inside. And you see the person who came worrying is not dancing on the stage. He's smiling. They ask him, why are you smiling? What? He said, I'm drunk with my own money. I'm so just happy. No one gave me. I just happy. But someone, because you know that when I have a problem, to change the problem to joy, I need something. But as when we go in prayer, we receive the drunkenness of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We are filled with the Holy Spirit. The power of God comes in your heart. The power comes on you. You stand there, people are amazed. Why you always smile? But you don't have a job. Why you always smile? You don't have a car. Why you don't always smile? You don't have money. Why? Because I am drunk with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. I am drunk. I always sing for God. I always dance for God. Nothing can stop me. I change my worries to praise. And I've changed the direction. Now I let all my petition, my concern to God. I say, God, you are the answer. Hallelujah. Your worries will never change your life. You can worry now till tomorrow morning. Nothing can change. Hallelujah. Let's take this one, the last one we're going to pray. Psalm 34. Verse 4, verse 6. Someone must say, pray now. Bless this month. Amen. Psalm 34, verse 4 to verse 6. I sought the Lord. It means that I looked for the Lord. I was seeking God. And he did what? Shout. And did what again? You see the result of prayer. Can you see that? When you seek the Lord, he will answer you. And also, the things that are making you afraid, he will deliver from that. Amen. What is making you afraid, he will deliver you. What is making you afraid now? You know, I'm counting days. They gave me the deadline in 48 hours. Now you are afraid. Something is tender. I don't know what will happen. God said that when you seek me, I will answer you. That situation that is stealing your sleep, I will deliver you from it. Give you deliverance. Give you victory from it. You see the power of prayer? Are you ready to pray today? God will take it away. That situation that makes you afraid. Amen. You sit there, the doctor put you in appointment. Next month, the 15th, you are going to operation. You are afraid. You know, I don't know what will happen. God can take it away. Can take it away. Anything that makes you fear, God can take it away. And I pray for you today, anything causing fear in your heart, God is taking it in charge. God is taking it away. God is giving you freedom. God is giving you deliverance. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Nothing will intimidate you. Receive the joy of God. Receive the miracle. Receive the grace. In Jesus' name, all your fears will go away today. Verse 5. Those who look to him, look to him. Not on men, they look on God. Are radiant, their face are shining with what? With joy. If you focus on God, your face will not lack joy. Their faces will never be ashamed. Shame will not be your portion. If you look on God, not on men, not on your situation, but on God. Put your eyes not on your problem, but on God. Change your focus. Your face will not be ashamed. You will always have a smile and a testimony. This is my prayer for you in this month of May. Look on God and your face will not be ashamed. Those who are waiting for you to be ashamed, they will be confused to see you smiling. They were waiting for you to cry. They will see you testifying because you are looking on God, not on men. The last verse 6. This poor man cried. Hallelujah. This poor man cried. And the Lord heard him. And he saved him from all his trouble. God is the God who saved the poor. He's the God who saved those who are in trouble. He's the God who saved those who are crying. He's the God who can save those who are in ultimatum. They don't know what to do. God is the one who can save them. I am that poor man who's crying today. Oh Lord, answer me. Oh Lord, come on my rescue. Oh God, lift me up in this month of May. Oh God, open new financial doors for me this month. Oh God, remove the shame upon my life. Oh God, remove the reproach. God, my eyes are on you. Hallelujah. 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 Do you believe he can do that? Do you believe if you focus on him, you'll receive a miracle? This month of May is your month of grace. Hallelujah. You don't believe, say, it is your month of grace. It is your month of grace. Your month of testimony. Your month of favor. The Lord is going to lift someone here. The Lord is going to visit a family here. Stand up where you are if you believe what I'm saying. It is your time. It is your season. It is the time for breakthrough. I know you have a problem. This poor man cried. It is time for you to lift your voice and to cry to God. And God will hear you today. Because his presence is here. And God will save someone here from all your trouble. It is true, maybe you put yourself in trouble, but God is a merciful God. He will take you out of that trouble. God knows that it was your mistake. He will take you up. God knows that you did not have someone to help you. He will take you up. He is the God. No matter your mistake, he is able to take you out. I say he is able to take you out. And God is taking someone out. God is taking your family out. He's taking your business out. Out of that trouble, you are coming with a testimony. You will have a miracle this month. The Lord is your shepherd. You shall not want. You will not go borrow money this month. You will not go crying to people. You will depend on God. The Lord is your provider. His name is Jehovah Jireh. I pray that God will provide for you this month. I pray that he will provide all your need this month. In the name of Jesus, the Lord is El Shaddai, the God Almighty. Any power fighting you, any demon fighting you, any plan of the enemy against your life, the Lord is setting you free. The Lord is setting you free today. The Lord is giving you a turnaround. I pray for you as I stand here. I pray for you as I stand here. That you are coming out of trouble. You are coming out of limitation. Yeah. You are coming out. Amen. In the name of Jesus. I declare favor upon your life.
Amen.
I bless your hand.
Ah.
I say, I bless your hand.
Amen.
I say again, I bless your hand.
Amen.
Let your hand be loaded.
Amen.
With the grace of God.
I
commend your hand to touch blessing this month. I commend your hand to increase money this month. I commend your hand to don't like in this month. I bless you today. I bless your hand today. The Lord is your God. The Lord is your shepherd. No enemy will defeat you. No witchcraft will defeat you. Every curse that was working against your life, I break it today. I break it today.
Amen.
I break it today.
Amen.
I stand against limitation.
Oh,
in the name of Jesus, I break limitation.
Amen.
I lose the power now.
Yes,
I release the anointing.
Yes,
I see someone running under the power, moving in another level.
Amen.
I see someone testifying God. The power of God is in this place.
Amen.
The power of God is in the house.
Yes,
the power of God is touching your life.
Amen.
God is setting you free.
Hallelujah.
Begin to receive my faith. It is your time. It is your season. Keep receiving my faith. Trust in the Lord. Alabroshake, you will not be deceived. Trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. Receive by faith. Trust in the Lord. Your time has arrived. 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 This month is the month of favor. Your time has arrived. Keep receiving by faith. Keep receiving by faith. Keep receiving by faith. Keep receiving by faith. Something is happening. I can feel the power. I can feel the glory. I can feel the hand of God upon someone here now. Keep receiving my faith. That situation is changing today. That situation is changing today. It is your time. Your business will not go down. Your business will not go down. Your business will not close. In the name of Jesus. Someone keep receiving. Put your trust in God. I don't know your problem. Tell God I receive my faith. I don't know your problem. Receive the solution. Receive that miracle. Begin to pray. Say, I receive it. Begin to pray. Say, I receive it. Begin to pray. Say, I receive it.
Receive Jesus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. I pray for you today. I pray for your miracle today. In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord is answering someone. The Lord is answering someone. The Lord is visiting someone.
Amen.
It is your time.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
It is your time.
Hallelujah.
The move of God is in this place.
Amen.
When God is present, His power is present.
Oh, yes.
And when you stand in front of His power, and you open your heart, the power of God will transform all your problems to solution. The power of God will come and change the situation. Because your trust is in the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Your trust is in God. Open your hand where you are. Open your hand and I bless you in the name of Jesus. I bless each one of you. I speak the blessing of God upon you.
Amen.
There is a sweet anointing in this place.
Jesus.
And I speak that blessing upon you.
Amen.
By this month of May, the grace.
Amen.
Locate you.
Amen.
Locate you.
Amen.
Keria brashoko tila mahalaba. Kiskatu rebakaya. The grace locate you.
Amen.
And the grace of God is coming right now like an electricity on someone here.
Jesus.
It's coming Jesus. Like an electricity. You feel that electricity all over your body, all over your body. It is the grace that is removing. It's like they are removing on you a mantle and they are putting something new on you. The mantle of God's grace is coming on you to give you another flavor in your life. Another flavor. Another flavor. I pray for you. I bless Rumbi in the name of Jesus. I bless Mama Jackie. I bless my brother Papi. I bless Bienvenue. I bless Milka. Today I'm blessing. I'm speaking blessing over each person today. You don't need me to come and lay my hand on you. As I'm speaking the blessing on you, the blessing is so powerful. It's on you. It's coming. It's working in the same time. The blessing is removing the curse. The blessing is bringing a new dimension. I bless you, Loic, with a great blessing of the Lord in this month of May. Let the blessing come on you like a mantle of grace that will take you into a new level. That will give you a new, I see the mantle of leadership coming on you, that you will be a great leader. The mantle is upon you. It's taking you another level. I pray for Mama Ellen in the same time. I pray for Papa Leopold in the same time. I pray for you. I speak the blessing of the Lord upon your life. I speak the visitation. I speak the move of God in your life, that your life will not remain the same. Anything that was delayed, anything that you were wanting to do, I pray for you. Receive the power. Receive the blessing. A new mantle on you. In the name of Jesus, the new mantle on you. I pray for my brother Burika. In the name of Jesus, I bless you today. I bless you. May the Lord answer the needs of your heart. I pray for Sister Emilia. I bless you today. I pray that God touches you today. That God will bring something new in your life. God will bring a new beginning in your life. In the name of Jesus. There is a mantle coming upon everybody here. I pray for you, Karabo. I speak the blessing of God upon your life. Let the Lord be your God. Let the Lord favor you. Let the Lord work in your life. In the name of Jesus. In the same time, I pray for Arlette. I speak the blessing on Arlette. I speak the blessing on Christelle. In the name of Jesus, may your hand be blessed. I break limitation and I declare increase in your life. Something is moving in this place. You just receive. You just receive. You just receive. A new dimension. I pray for you, Julia. In the name of Jesus, that the month of May, the favor of God will manifest in your life. I bless you today. As I'm walking in this place, I speak the blessing. Even on the children, I speak the blessing. I bless you again in the name of Jesus and your children and your family. I bless you today. Let the blessing come. Let the blessing locate you. I pray for you, Leslie. In the name of Jesus, may the blessing of the Lord walk with you in this month of May. May God give you the desire of your heart. I pray for Davina. In the name of Jesus, receive the blessing of God. Be blessed in this month. Walk with the blessing. In the name of Jesus, I pray for Beatrice. Keba ukasika cheya mandre baku ekereba shibra kuya araba ebre kozikete. I pray for the grace to locate you this month. God knows the plan that you have in your heart. God knows what you are planning to do. God knows the new level you want to enter. He knows that. He's speaking to me about a new level that you've been praying. You want to move in that level. You want to move in that condition. But God is telling me today, because you are here, the grace is upon you. And you are shifting in a new level. You are shifting in that new level. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I bless you, Sandrine. In the name of Jesus. Your house, your husband, children, I speak the blessing today. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you, Mimi. In the name of Jesus, the blessing. Everybody keep receiving the blessing.
Receive your blessing.
Keep receiving the blessing. Give me the melody.
Thank you, my
God. I pray for all the children that are present here today. In the name of Jesus, I bless each family. I speak the blessing on you, Peggy, and your house, and the children, and the passion. I bless you in this month of May. May you have a testimony. May God fight your battles. May God open new doors for you in the name of Jesus. I bless you, Tresor, in the name of Jesus. May the Lord be your defender. May the Lord walk with you. May the Lord promote you. May the Lord do you good in the name of Jesus. Rebecca, I pray for you today in the name of Jesus. The work of your hand be blessed. May the Lord be favorable to you. May the Lord create a new room for you. Anything that is stopping you now, I remove it in the name of Jesus. I pray that next week you will have more testimonies. The turnaround is coming on your direction in the name of Jesus. I bless you, Clement, in the name of Jesus. I speak the blessing over your life. I speak the favor over your life. May the Lord visit you. May the Lord walk with you. May the Lord lift you up in the name of Jesus. I pray for you, Jean-Claude, in the name of Jesus. Rema Kose, Makuyaka, Zibrekeya, Masketo, Zikete. May God visit your house. May God visit your wife in the name of Jesus. I bless you, Kali, in the name of Jesus. Rebakuseke, Mandibakusa, Okia Kaba. May the Lord be your God. May God be your blessing. Walk with favor. Strange favor this month. Strange grace this month. May the Lord answer your need and bless your house, bless your wife and your children in the name of Jesus. I bless you, Ben, in Jesus' name. Be blessed in this month. Let the work of your hand be blessed in the name of Jesus. I bless you, Richard, in Jesus' name. May God give you the blessing and his favor upon your life. I bless John and Gideon in Jesus' name. Mandre Kerebo, Zikareba. Let the Lord be your God. Let the Lord show you His grace, His mighty favor this month. I bless the entire family of Worshipers Sanctuary, even those who are not here today. I bless them in the name of Jesus. I bless every each house, every each business, every each marriage in the name of Jesus. I bless you today. I bless the Kambinda's family. Amen. I speak the blessing of the Lord upon this family. The protection of God over this family. The glory of God over this family. This month of May is the month of good news. Good news. Good news. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. Shekalabababa. Begin to thank God. Begin to thank God for your miracle. Be thankful.
Thank you, Lord, for the miracle.
Thank God for the miracle.
Thank you, for your words. Thank you, Jesus, for the life that is in your words, oh Lord.
Thank God for the miracle.
I thank you, Father.
It is done. The joy of the Lord is your strength. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Stand where you are in the same attitude. We are sealing now the blessing. We are sealing. We put the stamp on this blessing with the blood of Jesus. As we take the Holy Communion, we said, my blessing will never be stolen.
Amen.
No one will steal my blessing. There is a spirit.